वैष्णवेर क्रिया मुद्रा विकीना मुचाय सो ए हाईली एडवांस्ड वैष्णवा लिव्स इन सच अ वे दैट नो वन कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट ही इज और व्हाट ही वाज वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू अंडरस्टैंड ओके व्हाट ही इज नाउ एंड व्हाट ही वाज अर्लियर इट्स वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू फाइंड आउट द वैष्णवा लिव्स लाइक दैट नॉट योर अटेम्प्ट्स बी मेड टू अंडरस्टैंड द पास्ट ऑफ द वैष्णवा And I would try to understand also the past life of Vaishnava. What he was doing earlier. What, now he is a Vaishnava. No? He is doing everything nice. Okay, that's it. No need to understand or know earlier life. Without asking the same person about his previous life, Prahlad Maharaj immediately offered him respect. To his. He is not asking earlier what he was doing. No? But he just paid for him. तम नत्वा भर्च्य विधिवत तम नत्वा भर्च्य विधिवत पादयो शिरसा स्पृशन विविदसुर इदं अप्रक्षीन महाभागवतो सुरः तम हिम द सेंटली पर्सन नत्वा आफ्टर ऑफरिंग ओबिसेंस टू अवर्चर्य अवर्यच्य एंड वर्शिपिंग विधिवत इन टर्म्स ऑफ द रूल्स एंड रेगुलेशंस ऑफ Etiquette, Pada Yoga, the Lotus Feet of the Saintly Person, sits down with the head, discretion, touching, with so desiring to know about the Saintly Person, Idam, the following of Prakar. She inquired, Mahabhagavataha, the very advanced devotee of the Lord, Asura, although born in Asura. The advanced devotee, Prahlad Maharaj, duly worshipped and offered obeisance to the Saintly Person who had adopted a python's means of life. After thus worshipping the saintly person and touching his own head to the saint's lotus feet, Prahlad Maharaj, in order to understand him, inquired very submissively as follows. Okay, so people worshipped him with a desire to know about him. Prahlad spoke as follows. Prahlad Maharaj now will ask him. Vibrashi kayam pivanam sadyam bhagavan yatha. Vittam chayvodhyama Vittam chayvodhyama vattam bhago Bhogo vittvatamiha Bhaginam khalu devayam Viva bhavati Danyatha Vibharsi you are maintaining kayam a body Vivanam fat Saudhyam one who endeavors Bhagavan one who enjoys Yatha and Vittam Manisha also eva satyani kutyam vatam, a person always engaged in economic development. Boga, sense gratification, with vatam, for a person who possesses considerable wealth. Iha in this world, boginam of the interest, karmi is indeed deha, body, I am this. Viva, very fat, bhavati becomes nano and anyatada. Seeing the saintly person to be quite fat, Prahlad Maharaj said, He was not at all going anywhere and following Ajagati. Okay. But still, he was quite fat. Now, this is new conversation is going to start between Prahlad and this simply person who is following Ajagati. Means, he will not go anywhere. He will stay one place. Whatever comes, he will eat. That's it. But still he was very fat, quite fat. So Prahlad Maharaj asked him, My dear sir, and first Prahlad Maharaj paid obeisances, touched his feet, his head at the lotus feet of that saintly personality. And now he's asking very submissively, in a previous sloka says now, very submissively he asked, not jokingly, not out of ego, so very submissively. Even though Prahlad is a king, but still he asks very sincerely, My dear sir, you undergo no endeavor to earn your livelihood. You are not doing anything to work or to earn money or your livelihood. But you have a stout body. You are quite healthy. Exactly like that of a materialistic enjoyer. Like outsiders, people, materialistic people, they are eating too much and working, but they are having a very strong body, but you are also having I know that if one is very rich and has nothing to do, he becomes extremely fat. One is very rich and nothing to do. he becomes extremely fat by eating and sleeping and performing no work. He will eat, sleep, no work. He become fat. So, you have a fat body. Like people who do so much endeavor for enjoyment, they have such a fat body. And a man who endeavors, he becomes wealthy. And then the wealthy men enjoy it. And then they become fat. Otherwise, generally, if suppose somebody is having no food, no enjoyment, how, no wealth, how he become fat? Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur did not like his disciple to become very fat in the course of life. He would become very anxious upon seeing his fat disciples becoming bhogis or enjoyers. This attitude is here confirmed by Prahlad Maharaj, who was surprised to see a saintly person adopting a jagrati and become very fat. Saintly person and very fat, Prahlad Maharaj was wondering how it is. Okay. In the material world also, we generally see that when a man who is poor and skinny gradually endeavors to earn money through business or some other means and then gets money, he enjoys the senses to his satisfaction. By enjoying the senses, one becomes fat. Therefore, in spiritual advancement, becoming fat is not at all satisfactory. Okay. So, but here, what is the point? Here, Pivanam is indicating that you cannot say that your body has become fat simply by nature. Those who endeavor become wealthy. Okay, so generally, body does not become fat just like that. We have to, people endeavor, they enjoy, they work, eat so much, then we become fat. But for a spiritual people, this is not recommended that they become fat. Okay, 18th. Okay. Na te shayanasya nirudamasya grahannuharto yata eva bhogaha abhogino ayam tava vipradeha piva yatastat ना छेम चेता ना छमम चेता. ओके ना नॉट दे ऑफ यू संन्यास्य लाइंग डाउन श्यान श्यानस्य लाइंग डाउन निर्दिवस्य विदाउट एक्टिविटी ब्राह्मण पोसेंटली पर्सन टू ईट हा इट इज डिफरेंट अर्था मनी तथा फ्रॉम व्हिच एवा इट होगा सेंस एग्जामिन अभोगिना. Of one who is not engaged in sense enjoyment, I am this, tava, yava, vipra, all learned from deha, body, pipa, fat, yata, how is that? That fat way of vada, kindly tell na as chum, I spew, chet, if I have asked an impudent question. O Brahman, Napalamar is asking, O Brahman, fully in knowledge of transcendence, you have nothing to do, and therefore you are lying down. It is also understood that you have no money for sense enjoyment. How then has your body become so fat? Under the circumstances, if you do not consider my question impudent, kindly explain how this has happened. So generally, those engaged in spiritual advancement take food only once, either in the afternoon or in the evening. If one takes food only once, naturally he does not become fat. The learned sage, however, was quite fat, and therefore Pradhan Maharaj was very surprised. Because of being experienced in self-realization, a transcendentalist certainly becomes bright-faced. And one who is advanced in self-realization must be considered to possess the body of a Brahman. Because the bright-faced, saintly person was lying down and not working, and yet was quite fat, Prahlad Maharaj was puzzled and wanted to question him about this. Kavi kalpo nipondra chitra priya katha samahalo kasya purvata karma sheshe tati chita piva. कवि ही वेरी लर्नेड कल्पा एक्सपर्ट निपुण अतिरिक्त इंटेलिजेंट चित्र प्रिय कथा एबल टू स्पीक पैलेटेबल वर्ड्स दैट आर प्लीजिंग टू द हार्ट समाहा बाय लोकस ऑफ द जनरल गुरुवता इंगेजिंग टर्म ब्यूटीफुल शेषे यू लाई डाउन तत वीक्षिता सीइंग देम ऑल अपी ऑल द वा ईदर Your honor appears learned, expert, and intelligent in every way. You can speak very well, saying things that are pleasing to the heart. You see that people in general are engaged in beauty of peace, yet you are lying here inactive. Prahlad Maharaj studied the bodily features of the saintly person and through the saint's physiognomy, Prahlad Maharaj could understand that he was intelligent and expert. Although he was lying down and not doing anything, Prahlad was naturally inquisitive about why he was lying there. Okay. Simple thing. He was thinking why you are lying down. He understood that he was intelligent and expert. Okay, that's why he is saying that you see that people in general are engaged in some activity, some future, some work, some job. But you are simply inactive, no, not doing anything. Still you are fat. What is the point here? Sri Narada Vacha Saitam Dethya Patina Paripushto Mahamni Isme Manas Tamabhyaya Tadvagam Vritu Yandritaha Sri Narada Vacha. The great Saint Naradmuni said, Saha, the saintly person lying down, in this way, Dethya Patina, by the king of the Dethyas, Prahlad Maharaj. Paripristha, being sufficiently questioned. Mahamuni, the great saintly person. Smayamana, smiling, come unto him, Prahlad Maharaj. Abhyatha, who did the answer, Tattva, of his word, Amritya, being captivated by him. We are reading 7th canto, 13th chapter, text 20. Okay? Translation. Naradmuni continued, when the saintly person was thus questioned by Prahlad Maharaj, the king of the Daityas, he was captivated by his shower of nectarine birds and he replied to the inquisitiveness of Prahlad Maharaj with his smiling face. So now the Brahman, that saintly person, will speak. Sri Brahman Uvacha Vedenam Surasrestha Bhavan Nanyavarya Sammada Iyo Paramayor Nirnam Padanyan Yatma Chakshusha. Sri Brahman Uvacha, the Brahman replied, Veda, no, very well, Vedam, all these. Best of the strength of indeed, Arya Samhita, whose activities are approved by civilization, yeah, of Paramayo, of increasing the name of the people in general, Padani, Adhyatma, Chakshita, Vital Central Eye. The saintly Brahmin said, O best of the Asuras, Prahlad Maharaj, who are recognized by advanced and civilized men, you are aware of the different stages of life because of inherent transcendental eyes. Prahlad is Prahlad, such a great devotee of the Lord. So, with which because of your inherent transcendental eyes, with which you can see a man's character and thus how really the results of acceptance and rejection of things are as they are. Okay, so he's saying that you are anyway great devotee, Prahlad, you are already aware of different stages. Because of your transcendental inherent eyes, with which you can see a man's character and thus know clearly the realms of acceptance and the realms of things as they are. Okay, Prahlad, the devotee, a pure devotee like Prahlad Maharaj can understand the minds of others because of his pure vision in devotional service. Will understand. Devotees can understand it. Like what you are thinking. So, devotee like Prahlad Maharaj can study another man's character without it. Yes, Narayano Devo Bhagwan Rudataha Sada Bhaktya Keval Yajnanam Dhunoti Nantam Arkavak. Yes, of whom Narayana Deva, the Supreme Personality of God, Narayana Bhagwan, the Lord, Hitrada in the core of the heart Sada, always Bhaktya by devotional service, Kevalya alone, Ajnanam, ignorant, Dhunoti, Kilim, Nantam, Arkavak, as the Sada. Narayan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is full of all opulences, proud, predominant within the core of your heart because of your being a pure devotee. He always drives away all the darkness of ignorance as the sun drives away the darkness of confusion. The word bhaktya kevalya indicates that simply by executing bhakti in devotional service, bhaktya kevalya, simply by devotional service, one can become full of all knowledge. Krishna is the master of all knowledge. Aishwaryasya samagrasya virasya shashriya. The Lord is situated in everyone's heart. Ishvara sarvatanam hridayesh arjun tishtati. And when the Lord is pleased with the devotee, the Lord instructs him only to the devotees. However, does the Lord give instructions by which to advance further to others, the non-devotee, the Lord gives instructions according to the manner of their surrender. Okay, to the devotee, Lord gives instruction from within the heart to advance further in devotional service. Okay, Krishna says that, Aham dadami buddhyam, how you can come to me, that intelligence I will provide. But for the other people, non-devotee, the Lord gives instruction according to the manner of their surrender. So the pure devotee is described by the words bhaktiya kevalya. Sri Krishna Chakri Thakur explains that bhaktiya kevalya means jnana karmadi amishraya, unmixed with studio activity or speculative. Jnana karmadi anapratam. Simply surrendering at the lotus feet is the cause of all a devotee's enlightenment and awareness. The devotee is always intelligent, aware, he knows everything. How? Because he has surrendered at the lotus feet of Krishna. Because of his bhakti. Out of bhakti gives everything actually. Jnana, knowledge and vairagya, detachment comes as a result, as the side effect of bhakti. This is the byproduct. The main product of bhakti is Krishna Prema. But this Gyan, Vairagya, other good qualities will come as a byproduct of bhakti. So one should not endeavor like Jnana or other things. It will come. Whatever is required, knowledge, Krishna will reveal that knowledge. Problem solved. Okay. Tathapi Brumae Krishna's Tava Rajanyatashritam Sambhashaniyo Iki Bhagavan Atna Shukhita. Tapi still Brumae, I shall answer Krishna Tava Yo Rajanyatashritam. And by reading from the 30th, Sambhashaniya for being addressed, Iki Bhagavan, you Atmana of the Self Supreme, will be given Shukhita by one. My dear King, although you know everything, you have posed some questions, which I shall try to answer according to what I have learned by hearing from authorities. I cannot remain silent in this regard. For a personality like you, it's just fit to be spoken to by one who desires self-education. See, just a nice thing is shown here. The Prahlad Maharaj is already a pure devotee, Mahajan, but is still very humbly, submissively, he is asking another saintly person some question. Another person is saying, dear Prahlad Maharaj, you are already a great devotee, Mahajan, but still you are asking me. Prahlad Maharaj is saying, you are already a Mahajan. Okay, so there is nothing which is unknown to you. This is the nice etiquette of asking. Prahlad Maharaj asking question, considering himself low, submissively, he's taking a lower position. So when we ask question, we have to take that lower position, that I don't know, that mood should be there. You know? Mood should not be, I have to check whether the speaker knows or not. No. I should have a mood that I don't know, so let me ask from him. That is the moment. Prahlad Maharaj is very submissively asked, please tell me. And the other person also understanding the position of Prahlad Maharaj, so saying, my dear Prahlad Maharaj, you are already Mahajan. You know everything already, but still you are becoming humble and taking a position of a seeker and asking me. So I shall try to answer whatever you have asked. And he is saying, I shall try to answer according to what I have learned by hearing from authority, from my authority. I'm not going to tell you the answer just like out of my speculation. I am going to tell you the answer which I have heard from my authorities. Okay, so this is the proper conversation. The speaker tells whatever he heard from the previous acharyas, and a seeker or disciple or student asks very submissive, not in the mood of challenge or a checking, like whether, let me find out whether the speaker knows this or not. They will ask some typical question just to break. See, you don't know. That way, you may prove that, you know, in this way, we may prove that a speaker don't know. But what is the point here? You may never understand the point. So ask, we should ask question for our improvement, our self-realization, our upliftment, not for checking the knowledge of the speaker. A saintly person does not wish to speak to anyone and everyone, and he is therefore grave and silent. Okay, so if you see, it is mentioned here, the devotees will understand the mind of the people. Okay, so when we go and ask some devotee some question in a challenging mood or in an examination mood, they'll understand and they will avoid your question. They'll not give much answer, like simply, you know, they will say something and move. But if you submissively ask, they may give some time and explain in a full broader perspective. Okay. Otherwise, devotees will remain silent. They do not bother much. So you see, so many devotees travel in train and all. They don't speak to too many people, just like if somebody asks submissively, they will tell them. Otherwise, they will not bother. No. They are not. Devotees does not show, I know. No. If you ask, they will submissively tell. But if you ask in challenging mood, they will not. Somebody asked me once, okay, I want to. They were from some other spiritual organization. So they came, they met just like that, and they were asking, can we have some discussion over this matter? We want to know what is your understanding of this. I said, okay, what is your understanding? So they said, we believe like this. I said, that's right. I have defeated Hare Krishna. Why to waste our time? You won. I am defeated. Okay, you go. I have not such time for such debates, right? For unnecessary debates. You want to challenge? I'm defeated. Hare Krishna. Problem solved. Okay, you remain victorious. Be happy. Okay. Somebody comes for asking some help. I want to understand this. Then I can put some time and we can together help each other. That is the way. But challenging mood is not. That's why. Otherwise, they will remain silent. So generally, a common man does not need to be advised. Unless one is prepared to take instructions, it is said to that a saintly person should not address, although sometimes because of great kindness exposed to us. Generally, to simple, normal people, they should not speak. Sadhu, they will not speak. When they ask, then only sadhu should speak. But in some very specific situation, somebody is really in pathetic situation, they are out of great kindness, sometimes Babu's will may speak to them. Okay. As for Prahlad Maharaj, however, since he was not a common ordinary man, whatever question he posed would have to be answered by a great and exalted person. Therefore, the saintly Brahman did not remain silent but began to answer. These answers, however, were not concocted by him. This is indicated by the word Yatha Srutam. This word Yatha Srutam came many times. Maitreya also said Yatha Srutam Yatha Aditam. Many times this word Yatha Srutam Yatha. Here again is Yatha Srutam. How? Whatever I have heard from authorities, I am going to tell. Meaning, as I have heard from the authority in the Parampara system, and the question are bona fide. And the questions are bona fide, the answers are bona fide. No one should attempt to create or manufacture answers. One must refer to the Shastras and give answers according to the things. The word Yatha Srutam referred to Vedic. The Vedas are known as Shruti because this knowledge is received from authorities. The statements of the Vedas are Shruti Paramana. One should quote evidence from the Shruti, the Vedas, or Vedic, and then one's statement correct. Otherwise, one's words will proceed from mental concoction. So, whatever one should speak, it should have a spiritual reference somewhere from some Shastra. That's why Prabhupada, whatever he speaks, he gives. Shlokas out of behind it, right? Trishnaya bhavahinya yogeka me puriyaya karmani karamanam nana yomshu yojita. Trishnaya, because of material desires, bhavahinya, under the sway of the three laws of nature, yoga has been yogeka me by material desires, puriyaya, without ending one after another. Karmani activities, karya mana, constantly being compelled to perform am ainana yamshit by his mantra by yojita in case of that struggle for existence. Because of insatiable material desires, I was being carried away. Now this saintly person is telling. Because of insatiable material desires, I was being carried away by the waves of the righteous thought, and thus I was engaging in different activities, struggling for existence, various forms of life. As long as a living entity wants to fulfill various types of material desire, he must continuously change from one body to accept another body. Okay. Srila Vishnu Chakri Chakra explains that as a small piece of grass falls in a river and is tossed about the different types of wood and tree branches, the living entity floats in the ocean of material existence and is dashed and tossed amidst material conditions. This is called the struggle for existence. Okay, nice and beautiful. Prabhupada is saying, as long as a living entity wants to fulfill various types of material desires. As long as we have material desires, maybe it is for sense gratification, name, fame, whatever it is, material desire, one must take another body, change from one body to another body. This will happen unless we have material desires. So we have to convert all the desires into spiritual desires. No more material desires. Only spiritual desires. Anya Vilashitash. One kind of fruitive activity causes the living being to take one form of body, and because of actions performed in that body, another body is created. So one action is done, as a result of that, another body we got. In that body, another action is done, another body is created. This goes on. One must therefore we must stop these material activities, and the chance to do so is given in the human form of life. Okay, in human form of life, this chance is given that we can break this cycle, this system. One body, another body. Specifically, our energy to act should be engaged in the service of the Lord, for then materialistic activities will automatically stop. So in human, see, as long as we are performing these materialistic activities, we will be getting new body, birth after death, after birth, death, birth, death. this will go on. So when one comes in the human life, he can break this. How this cycle, birth, death cycle, he can break. How he can stop material activities. But stopping material activities is very difficult because he must do some activities. So easiest way of stopping material activities is start spiritual activities. Simply you cannot just sit like that, now I am not doing it. So start spiritual activities, devotional activities, then materialistic activities will automatically stop. This is the point. Automatically it will stop. No need to worry too much. Okay. Because a person is engaged in spiritual activities, he has no time for material activities. He is fully engaged there. You know? So how will you get time? Automatically it will stop. So easiest way of stopping birth and death is stop material activities. Easiest way of stopping material activities is start devotional spiritual activities. Okay. So one must fulfill one's desires by surrendering unto the Supreme Lord, for he knows how to fulfill them. Any desire you have, you go and surrender to Krishna. Krishna knows everything, how to fulfill. Okay. Even though one may have material desires, one should therefore engage in the devotion of service of the Lord. That will purify one's struggle for Krishna. Even for the material desires, one should go to Krishna. Akama sarva kamo va moksha kamo daradi vibhena bhakti yogene jeta purusham param. And many times this sloka has come. You must be knowing now. A person who has broad intelligence, whether he be full of all material desires, akama sarva kama, no desire, all the desire or desire for liberation. Without any material desire or desiring liberation, must be all meet worshippers, all the person. In all the situation, what is the recommended process? Tibrena bhakti yogena yajeta purusham param. Worship purusham param Krishna, how? Bhakti yoga. Simple. It is very simple actually. Okay, anya vilashita shunyam gyan karma adinagata maakuleni Krishna silenam bhakti ruttama. What is the uttam bhakti? Top class of bhakti is one should render transcendental loving service to the Supreme Lord Krishna. How? Anukulena. Uttam bhakti means Krishnanu shilanam bhakti rutma. But how? Anukulena. Favorably serve Krishna with love and without desire for material profit or gain. Anya vilasana. All other desires should be Krishna. Nature of desire should be Krishna. No other. By nature, he is not desiring anything else than service to Krishna. Okay, without desire for material profit or gain through the activities or philosophical speculation, jnana karana karmadi anavritam. That is called pure devotion. Okay, yadra chaya loka mimam prapta. Swarga to the heavenly plane, Apavarga to liberation, Dwaram the gate, Tirasham, lowest piece of life, Punaha, again Asya of the human nature, and in the course of the evolutionary process, which is caused by future activities due to undesirable material sense gratification, I have received this. What is that? Who is saying? Saintly personality saying to Prahlad Maharaj that in the course of evolutionary process, this 84 lakh species, that process, which is caused by my karma, due to activities, due to, and why that? Due to undesirable material sense gratification. because of having so much material sense gratification, I got this reaction of karma, and I was in the evolutionary process many species, and then I have received this human form of life. Now, 84 lakh species cycle is there. As per karma, they may go, to bodies, and now they are in the. Now I am in the human form of life, which can lead to heavenly planets. Now in this human form of life, I can go swarga also. I can go apavarga. What is that? Swarga apavarga. Swarga means human form, a heavenly planet, and apavarga means liberation. Or also I can go to the lower species. Again I can go to the lower species, animals. Or to rebirth among human. So now a human form has come. Okay. So anything can happen now. It said that in human form, you have a choice to select, actually. Swarga. From the human form, you can go to Swarga, demigods, Devata, you can go. Apavarga, you can get Mukti. And Tirascham, lower species. Otherwise, puna asyacha, or you can become same like human again. This is the point. All living entities within this material world are undergoing the cycle of birth and death according to the laws of nature. This struggle of birth and death in different species may be called the evolutionary process, but in the Western world, it has been wrongly explained. Evolutionary process is the evolution in the consciousness of the jiva. But in Western world, they explained wrong. They said evolution in the body. Darwin's theory of evolution from animal to man is incomplete because the theory does not present the reverse condition, namely evolution from man to man. In this verse, however, evolution has been very well explained on the Vedic authority. Human life, which is obtained in the course of the evolutionary process, is a chance for elevation, swarga, pavarga, or for degradation, tirascham, punarasya. If one uses this human form of life properly, he can elevate himself to the higher planetary system where material happiness is many thousands of times better than on this planet. Or may cultivate knowledge by which to become free from evolutionary process and be stated in one's original spiritual life. This is called apavarga or liberation. Material life is called pavarga. This is very important, huh? Very interesting also. The material life is called pavarga because here we are subject to five different states of suffering, represented by the letters pa, pa, ba, bha, and pa. Okay, this pavarga, why this material world is called pavarga? Because this comes from the varnamala, alphabets, you know, Sanskrit or Hindi. So there are different vargas, ka varga, kha varga, cha varga, ta varga, ta, like that, pavarga, ta varga. Ka varga, ka, kha, ga, ga, ya. So this pa fa ba ga ma, this is called pavarga because it starts with pa. Cha cha ja ja na, this starts with cha, so it's called cha varga. Ta ta da da na,